When all of this started, everyone wanted to do as much as they could do to help with the situation to the COVID crisis. We do have 3D printing capability, so we lead sort of the transversal program across Saint-Gobain. Then we heard about the face mask design that Sage had downloaded. It's an open source design. The team in Mike Lemberger and Boris just sort of took it and started running with it very quickly.
Within Northboro R&D, within the CRL group, we have tremendous expertise on processing, and everybody were thinking, how can we help? How can we help? What can we do?
We started with 3D printing. We made face shields, and then we made some prototypes of masks. Through Boris Serebrennikov, who is the group leader for the injection molding area, he said, we can injection mold these masks. We can make thousands of masks a day. So we agreed that we would make masks.
To date, we made about 12,000 masks. The plan is just to continue making them for another several weeks. We used the design that we took from a public source.
They were made by a group of doctors in Montana.
They found out that the mask is quite effective for protecting from the spread of the virus. The mask is injection molded. It's molded out of polypropylene. You can use it for a very long time. It's not single use.
This and or the rigid one can actually go in the dishwasher, can go in the washing machine.
So the advantage of the plastic masks is that you only need a 2.5-inch square to create the filter area.
This definitely provides a different option, and it uses a lot less fabric, and a lot of these fabrics have been in short supply.
We are currently in the process of making the ear savers, which is just a plastic strip that goes on the back of your ears.
And so this allows you to sort of relieve that and put the tension across the back of your head.
Currently, there's about 15 people that have volunteered to spend time out on the line.
We have a volunteer sheet for people to do 6-hour shifts. So we've actually had so many people that we have to like kind of push them back a little bit because there's so many people at the center that want to help out. It was amazing that we basically got everything running, going in like a week and a half.
We're going to be donating them internally to Saint-Gobain manufacturing locations so that it could be used on the shop floor. Dennis Wilson wanted to have a variety of masks on the floor so that operators could choose the ones that they like.
I'm actually wearing one. It's one of the first ones I made. I've been wearing it for weeks now. I actually like it for like my glasses fog up a lot. With this, I actually can wear my glasses, which are required here, safety glasses on. So that's a plus for me.
We donated a number of these to the Northboro, Massachusetts Fire and Police Departments for them to have. We also made some donations of other hospitals, nursing homes. It's been a nice team effort for sure.
We're a large global company that is helping their communities locally.
With the resources that this company has, we definitely can help. This is kind of, to some point, our duty to help the communities that are around us and that support the company, and we have to support them.
It's part of our culture to do the right thing, and it's part of our culture to take care of each other.